Yeah, I'm just calling up. I suppose I'm just a little bit perturbed at how quickly people seem to be able to overlook Donald Trump's racism, his misogynist tendencies, all of these things. It seems very quick that, you know, we're looking to this man as a savior. In fact, if anything, I mean, this, let's face it, I mean, he's pulled the wool over the eyes of the American public that he was some great savior coming to save them, the working class hero. It's a joke, really. I mean, he was born a millionaire, and now we're all sort of happy to call him this savior. What has led us to believe?
What do you mean by we? You certainly don't.
No, but certainly you and your listeners seem very content to call him the new savior.
No, I've never called him the new savior. Never anything like it.
Well, he's certainly not intelligent in the way that you seem to give him props for. He's intelligent.
Hang on.
Yeah.
Who are you to say that? That's your opinion. That's your opinion. But who are you to give a definitive opinion on it?
I'm just going to give you my opinion.
Well, you made a statement. You said a certainty. He certainly is not intelligent.
Well, okay. He's certainly not truthful. And that we can actually quantify.
Okay, name me a president in your memory who is truthful.
Look, I'm not going to go here and try to say that every single... Obviously, politicians work things to their advantage, but we've never seen anybody like this school bully who's able to manipulate situations to his advantage. And let's not get it screwed here. It's for his advantage. Not for the people's advantage, not for anybody else's, and this is a huge promo exercise.
And on what basis do you make the comment that it's to his advantage?
What? Because he's trying to flip the script, that he's the savior, that he's the one coming in and making all of this possible. I'm just saying, let's